open their lips. Make speed to save us. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost.
As it was in the beginning, is now.
Welcome to the Office of Choral Evensong, and if you're joining us online, it's lovely to have you with us for our service and for our congregation behind me and all those who come to pray in the cathedral today. We continue with our worship with our psalm today, Psalm 47. The first lesson is taken from the book of the Song of Solomon, chapter 4, beginning to read at the 16th verse. Awake, O north wind, and come, O south wind, blow upon my garden, that its fragrance may be wafted abroad. Let my beloved come to his garden and eat its choicest fruits. I come to my garden, my sister, my bride. I gather my myrrh with my spice.
I eat my honeycomb with my honey, I drink my wine with my milk. Eat, friends, drink, and be drunk with love. I slept, but my heart was awake. Listen, my beloved is knocking. Open to me, my sister, my love, my dove, my perfect one, for my head is wet with dew, my locks with the drops of the night. Set me as a seal upon your heart, as a seal upon your arm, for love is strong as death, passion fierce as the grave, its flashes as flashes of fire, a raging flame. Many waters cannot quench love, neither can floods drown it. If one offered for love all the health of one's health, it would be utterly scorned. Here ends the first lesson.
Thank you.
the second lesson from the Gospel according to St. Luke, chapter 22, from the 24th verse. Dispute also arose among them as to which one of them was to be regarded as the greatest. But he said to them, "The kings of the Gentiles lord it over them, and those in authority over them are called benefactors. But not so much with you. Rather, than the greatest among you must become like the youngest, and the leader like the one who serves. For who is greater than the one who is at the table, or the one who serves? Is it not the one at the table? But I among you as one who serves. You are those who have stood by me in my trials, and I confer on you, just as my Father has conferred on me, a kingdom, so that you may eat and drink at my table in my kingdom. And you will sit on thrones, judging the 12 tribes of Israel." Here ends the second lesson.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Ghost, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven, and sitteth on the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. The Lord be with you. Let us pray.
Lord, have mercy upon us. Christ, have mercy upon us. Lord, have mercy upon us.
upon us. Lord, save the Queen.
And mercifully hear us when we call upon thee.
Endure thy ministers with righteousness.
And
save thy people. Give peace in our time, O Lord.
Because there is none other that fighteth for us, but only
Redeemer, who has delivered us from the power of darkness and brought us into the kingdom of thy Son, grant that as by this death he may recall us to life, so by his continual presence in us he may raise us to eternal joy. Through Jesus Christ, thy Son, our Lord, who liveth and reigneth with thee in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
O God, from whom all holy desires, all good counsels, and all just works do proceed, give unto thy servants that peace which the world cannot give, that both our hearts may be set to obey thy commandments, and also that by thee, we, being defended from the fear of our enemies, may pass our time in rest and quietness through the merits of Jesus Christ, our Saviour.
Amen.
Lighten our darkness, we beseech thee, O Lord, and by thy great mercy, defend us from all perils and dangers of this night, for the love of thine only Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ.
Amen.
To lead us into our intercessions, the choir sing the anthem by Henry Purcell, O Sing Unto the Lord.
Thank you.
So we continue to pray. We come on this day when the organisation Christian Aid, that the week begins today, celebrates its 75th anniversary. We give thanks that God's love is revealed to the poorest in the world by transforming power through the hands and hearts of people who give and those who deliver. We pray especially for all who are in famine, poverty, distress, or disaster situations today, and for those who seek education, rehousing, life, and love. We give thanks for all whose responsibility in this cathedral is to collect for Christian Aid this year, for Mary Sawyer and her team, and all who will come next Sunday as we mark the 75th anniversary here in this cathedral. O God, to you we bring the needs of those communities that are struck down by disaster or famine, for the healing of those who are sick or in any way living in poverty. Give them strength and courage in this time of darkness and fear. And we pray for all who bring medical aid across the world at this time, especially those dealing with the coronavirus pandemic. Protect them as they tend the sick, so that they may remain healthy and strong to go where they are needed most. Grant that in our own comfort and blessings, we may never forget the needs of others and respond with love and compassion of Jesus Christ, our teacher, saviour and friend. Amen. And in the last few days, the countries of the United Kingdom have been electing representatives for their communities to serve as mayors, members of the Scottish Parliament, members of the Welsh Assembly, members of local councils, crime commissioners and police officers. We pray for John, who has been elected the crime commissioner for this county of Cheshire, for the new council for the Metropolitan Borough of the Wirral, of Stockport, of Trafford and of Tameside in this diocese, and for all who have stood as local mayors across this area, particularly those in Liverpool and the Liverpool City region that are in this diocese. And for the gift of democracy, how people may choose to elect who they represent. O Lord, we beseech thee to govern the minds of all who are called to office at this time, to choose faithful women and men into the great council of this nation, that they may exercise their choice as one that has been shown to them on paper, for the welfare of all people, in Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And as we remember this time of the end of the Easter season and the journey towards ascension, when our Lord Jesus Christ left this earth and called his disciples to be faithful until the coming of the Holy Spirit, we pray especially for all who ask for our prayers today. Pray especially for Yerwin Griffiths-Jones, Helen Newman, Rupert Harvey, Alan, Reg Taylor, Mike, Lorna Gray, and all those who are known to us. And as we remember those whose journey on this earthly life has come to an end, we remember especially Jim Askew, Azalea Kerr, Elizabeth Morris, Ken Murphy, Harry, and Sheila McGivering, praying for all their souls and those who leave them and those who are left behind. We thank you, O Lord, that our loved ones who have gone from our sight are in your keeping. Help us to leave them there in perfect trust, because you love them and us with infinite love. Grant that we may learn to know you better, so that we may meet them again in your presence through faith in him who loved us and gave himself for us, Jesus Christ, our Saviour. Amen. And so with the prayers of the Blessed Virgin Mary and all the saints, we offer ours in the silence of our hearts and pray for the blessing of God as we say the words of the grace together. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all evermore. Amen. So we now have our hymn, Lord Jesus Christ, you have come to us, you are one of us. The Spirit of truth lead you into all truth, give you grace to confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, and strengthen you to proclaim the works and works of God. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you and remain with you now and always. Amen. Amen.